Nikita Kejriwal, we are from River Mandakini. So before starting our presentation, I would like to show you a video to tell you about the topic that we are going to present today. So here's the video. So our topic for today is online cabs in India, and we are basically here to discuss about the short case study on OLA cabs. So let me take you to the scope and the contents that we are going to cover today. First, we'll discuss about the introduction, then the reasons why only OLA, its marketing strategies, services provided by OLA, its market share and its acquisitions. So coming to the introduction part, it was founded in 2010 by Bhavesh Agarwal and Ankit Bhati. It has around 450,000 plus vehicles, building mobility for Indians across country. It has around 6,000 plus employees who work effortlessly and immensely for providing better services and technology. Its services are spread in almost more than 110 cities. It has around over 10 lakh empowered driver partners who work for a better tomorrow. And its headquarters is in Bangalore, Karnataka. You can see the source from where we have gathered these information.
Now the basic question is why we are talking about OLA. So the question which comes to the mind is why OLA? So these are the basic reasons which I have gathered in a flow chart. So the first is a valuable startup. Since we all know OLA has been emerged as the largest ride sharing app. So it has been emerged as a valuable startup because Uber, which is the second largest competitor of OLA, which has emerged in 2013, as we all know, OLA has been founded in 2010. So basically, it is the first startup which is such successful. The second is affordable price with comfort. Now, I would like you all to know that what is the differentiating factor? What makes OLA as the highest ride-sharing taxi facility? So it is the affordable price, because we all know that OLA has different services which includes the prime as well as the auto. So auto is basically for the lower middle class as well as the people like us, the students, who basically believe in ride sharings as well as the auto pedals. So for them it is affordable price with comfort, like the price as well as the luxury. The third is woman driver promoter. So it has also initiated for the empowerment of women through woman driver promoter. It has been supported by NSDC and ASDC. Now it has also acted as a profitable cab aggregator. Now I would like to tell what is an aggregator. Now aggregator is a web software applications which enable to connect the customers which need the help and the company which is providing the help. So basically it is a software application platform which connects both. Now the next is CNG cab initiator, through which it is providing help to the environment. Now moving next, these are the marketing strategies which is followed by OLA, which makes OLA as a differentiator among the rest taxi companies, rental taxi companies. The first is segmentation, targeting and positioning. So basically what OLA has done is it has segmented the market based on three or four criteria. So one of the criteria is geographical criteria. So basically what OLA has done is OLA has differentiated its cab and autos on the basis of different criteria, like for metro cities as well as for the non-metro cities. There are different price ranges which they could afford. Now moving next, for the different income profile of the people, it has differentiated into prime, auto, etc. As well as for the different for the different income people as well as the segment it has differentiated, for which the OLA has acted as a differentiator among the many. Now moving next is strategic acquisitions. I would like all you to know that recently OLA has acquired Food Panda, it has acquired Riddler, it has acquired Taxi for Sure. So basically with this all acquisitions, what OLA is going to do is it is embracing its brand image so that people come to know more about OLA, and thus it can embrace its brand name. The next is promotional strategies. OLA has come across many advertisements through which we all come to know about the OLA. Since we have added a video, we all have seen the video. So basically that was the advertisement which they added up to act as a promotional strategy. The next is the distribution strategy. As she has explained earlier that in 110 plus cities, there are different and many auto drivers spread across the country through which they are proving their distribution strategies. And we all know that in every cities, OLA drivers are there, and for students as we, they act very helpful.
Now I would like to tell you about the services provided by OLA. So OLA has actually made changes in the app, and it has provided customers with choice to choose between taxis, outstation and rental outstations. You can see the categories of the services provided by OLA. I have mentioned different segment for OLA Auto because it was a good marketing strategy by OLA to bring OLA Autos, that is it, more cheap and affordable, and to cover large sections of society. OLA Auto also provides a good tracking system as it is a good aggregator. As she has explained what is aggregator, it provides a good platform for potential customers to connect with the person providing services.
Basically what it does it, the demand for auto has been met by this aggregator, and does it supply the facility which is basically needed. So basically what it does it, it provides a convenient, affordable and reliable facilities to all the customers who need them, and thus prove true to its brand image. Now this, I have included a picture of flower of service irrespective of explaining you through points. So the first is information. So basically these are the functions of a transportation service. So the first is information, and what OLA proves to is it through booking confirmation and car tracking, it provides the information to the respective customers. The next is consultation through route guidance, it provides the consultations to the customers. The next is order tracking. So via app, website and SMS, we all have come across this fact that we can track our orders. The next is hospitality. So through ACES, non-ACES, OLA Play and free Wi-Fi, it has served to all the sectors of the society and thus proved to the fact that it can even provide luxury with a reasonable price. The next is safekeeping through luggage and SOS. The next is exception, OLA Select and OLA Money. OLA, it has acquired, as I have already explained, it has acquired Taxi for Sure, which basically helps it for the OLA Money. Now next is hiring. So it has include inbuilt app bill and email bill. The next is payment. So basically payment is the main objective of that, and it has included cash payment and cashless payment. So it helps to prove to his brand image.
Now coming to the market share, as we can see the data, this is of data December 2017. OLA's market share stands at 56.2%, followed by Uber, that is 39.6%, followed by Jugnu, Ixigo and Meru. This is the source from where we have gathered this information. Now I would like to tell you about the acquisitions. OLA acquired Taxi for Sure worth 1200 crores in cash and stock. It was a good marketing strategy by OLA as it acquired one of its competitors, that is Taxi for Sure. OLA acquires Riddler to foray into public transport. Riddler is a public transport commuting and ticketing app. It acquired Riddler to stay alive in the competition. OLA also acquired Food Panda from delivery worth 1400 crores. Food Panda to strengthen and cover food delivering app in the market. OLA acquires mobile payments firm called Korth. So to conclude with, I would like to say that OLA has a tremendous... Okay, thank you.